This was the first installment of Tomorrowland on the Disneyland TV show. It aired on March 9, 1955. When you think of all that's happened in the decades since, it's remarkable how accurate it is in predicting what manned spaceflight would be like. But like most of the Tomorrowland shows, this one succeeds because it establishes a context for the subject. It talks about our fascination with space, and the moon in particular, going so far as to include Georges Méliès' famous 1902 movie, A Trip to the Moon.
Depends on how we define young people. You know, I've been going throughout America saying, if you can drive a car, you can see Saving Private Ryan, or even get your learner's permit at 15 years old, you can see the movie. And certainly, if you can fight in a war, as often our boys did at 17 years old in World War II, you search. But I think 14 years old and under, parents should be awfully careful about themselves judging whether their kids should see it or not. I personally did not let my younger kids see the picture.
But Kimball's sense of humor is also on display here in some clever and amusing animated sequences, not all of which are politically correct by today's standards. Incidentally, the show is narrated by Dick Tufeld, who does a typically fine job. If his voice sounds familiar, it's not just because he was one of the busiest radio and television announcers of all time. He was also the voice of the robot in the 1960s Irwin Allen TV series, Lost in Space.
But I simply interpreted, as a journalist sometimes has to do, what the veterans were personally telling me, what I had read about in books, and what I had seen in documentaries of that war, the Second World War. You know, I didn't want to make just another World War II picture that would not have withstood the test of time in the veterans' opinion.
This show turned out so well that Disney decided to release a somewhat shorter version of it to theaters as a featurette in 1956, accompanying Davy Crockett and the River Pirates. As a result, it qualified for the Academy Awards and earned an Oscar nomination as Best Documentary Short Subject. President Eisenhower requested a print to screen at the Pentagon, and the scale model of the space station built for the show was also sent to Washington, where it resides at the National Air and Space Museum. Man in Space was a giant step forward for Walt Disney and his audience.
Now hysteria's begun. Meet the boy named Kiddington. He is in almost every sketch, a Kiddington and his dog Fetch.
Well, howdy, y'all. Today we're talking about the dinosaurs who ruled the Earth for 180 million years.
So prepare yourself for
Hysteria
BC before comedy.
It's Loud Kiddington and his dog Fetch.
Hey, folks, Loud Kiddington here. And just when you thought your Stone Age life couldn't get any better, along comes the wheel!
It's the biggest thing since the rock!
My dog Fetch here will eat bat guano if I don't sell you a wheel!
Eat what? I'm not eating bat guano!
We'll discuss it later.
No, we won't!
Yes, the wheel! All new for 3002 BC!
It's time for
Hysteria
Special. But it's not an ordinary special, because today we go to 100 million years ago.
Today, we're gonna find out, because my guests are, guess who? The dinosaurs themselves.
Hi-de-ho, dinos.
Hello.
Hi there.
Nice to eat you. Meet you.
You're kidding, right?
No, ma'am.
Well, we're extinct. We were wiped out. You hadn't heard?
Hadn't heard what?
And I thought we were the ones with brains the size of peanuts.
Shh. Well, it all happened quite suddenly.
The food was excellent.
Speak for yourself.
Or, if you preferred, you could have a steak.
Fortunately, I like my steaks rare because that's the way they always came.
Occasionally, during a lightning storm, you might get a steak medium well.
But that was rare.
We ate out a lot, mainly fast food.
Yeah, we were on the go all the time. We'd eat and run.
And we'd run and eat.
I was kind of a meat and potatoes guy myself. Minus the potatoes, huh?
It's the sensation that's sweeping the Sumerian nation! Loud Kiddingtons! It's a giant supermarket of wheels!
Meanwhile...
SpongeBob! What's wrong?
I don't know, Mr. Krabs, but I've got the strangest feeling that somewhere a pirate and parrot are arguing about me. And the parrot is winning.
And then one day, we all saw this big ball of light up in the sky.
Yeah, it wasn't the sun, and it wasn't the moon.
We didn't know what it was.
It was this hot ball like a comet or some such cockamamie thing. Getting closer and closer.
So anyways, one of my buddies, Sid, he tries to catch it.
And when they died, that wiped out our food supply, too.
Yeah.
So eventually, we all got very hungry and dropped dead. Fade out, roll credits, end of story. And that's what happened to the dinosaurs. Extinction.
So come on down to Sumeria and buy a wheel! Cause if you don't, my dog Fetch here will eat a big pile of elephant plaw!
If you wanna buy a wheel,
I'll make you such a deal!
Go see loud, go see loud, go see loud!
Now hysteria is done! We hope you had a lot of fun! Tune in again and catch Loud Kiddington and his dog Fetch.